back to mildrawweekly.com.au. Today I'm joined by Deb, who is from a local initiative, Food Next Door. Thank you for coming in, Deb.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Now, firstly, for our viewers who may not know, would you be able to tell us a bit more about Food Next Door?
Yeah, so Food Next Door is a cooperative. We formed a couple of years ago in response to a need that we were hearing within the community for better access to more local produce. And we had a series of conversations and gatherings that really cemented this desire within the community to be able to buy and access more local produce. We started Food Next Door really with our weekly local produce box scheme called Out of the Box, and which I think we'll talk a bit more about that later. But after running at that for a trial period, we realised that there was actually a great need for more small-scale farmers in our region. And we had heard stories from people who'd grown up here from, you know, 20, 30 years ago, where there were a lot of market gardens and a lot of small-scale farmers. And that has really dropped away and been replaced by larger farms, generally growing food for export from our region. So we, around that time, also connected with some researchers who were looking at new migrant farmers who had moved into our region and were wanting to farm, but what they found was that they weren't able to farm because they didn't have the resources to access land. So we just happened to be in a position where we wanted to help, and there was a lot of energy at the time, and we decided to trial a land matching process where we'd identified some vacant land that the landholder was really happy to see being used to grow food on, but they didn't want to grow food there themselves. And so we were able to match that land with a group of farmers from Burundi, which is a country in East Africa, and the results were quite amazing. So the co-op has really grown from that, and one of the main things that the co-op does is this land matching process to try to regenerate some of the empty land in our irrigation district, and to do that by facilitating and supporting new migrant farmers to grow food on that land.
Yeah, fantastic. Mm. So you touched on before, like, the results have been fantastic. What are some of the most rewarding, I guess, results you have gained since starting up your operation?
Yeah, interestingly, I think for some of us, we were really interested in seeing the land regenerated using organic and regenerative farming practices. And for myself, I'm an ecologist, so I come from a scientific background, and have always been interested in conservation. And so that was what I was really interested in. But what we saw from that trial was this amazing sense of connection within our community, from kind of embracing these new migrant farmers and the skills that they had. And the stories that we heard from them, and I can't speak on their behalf, but those stories were around this sense of belonging and feeling like they were being acknowledged for the skills that they had within our community and able to contribute back to the community. So, and certainly from the broader community who were involved, has been so many volunteers, such a diversity of volunteers, that real sense of community and sense of belonging to something that's making a difference in the community is by far the most outstanding result, if you like.
That's fantastic. And as you mentioned before, you touched on your connection with the local organisation Out of the Box. Would you mind telling us more about that and how that operates?
Yeah, so Out of the Box is actually run by the co-op, by Food Next Door. So it's a social enterprise arm of the co-op, and we've been going for just over 2 years. And so the principle of Out of the Box, it's sort of on three different platforms, if you like. One is that there is a fair return to the grower, so we guarantee a minimum 50% return to the grower from the retail price, and we're really transparent about that, which is something that differs from our dominant food system, if you like, where when you're buying something from the supermarket or other places, you don't necessarily know how much of that is being returned to the grower. The other part of it is that the practices that the growers use are organic or regenerative practices, so they're building soil health and improving our soils and our land here in our region. And then of course the major thing, which is one of the reasons why a lot of people buy from out of the box, is that it's all local. So we have a about 100 kilometre radius, but most of the produce comes from probably within a 50 kilometre radius from small scale growers.
No, that's fantastic. And lastly, plans for the future, how do you see it going forward?
Yeah, so we're pretty busy at the moment. We've received some support from state government in particular to establish the community demonstration farm. So we've just finished installing all the irrigation there and testing that. And that will be ready for planting soon. We'll be starting with some cover crops and some green manure to really get some carbon and minerals and nutrients back into the soils before we start growing food. But I think what we're really excited about there is seeing different growers from different backgrounds with different skill levels growing beside one another, and be really interested to learn the exchange between those growers.
Definitely.
One of the things that we hear about, and the researchers I mentioned before from University of Melbourne and Wollongong wrote about these you know, over the fence learnings from growers, so from you know, Italian migrants who came in and started growing grapes, they have particular techniques that established Australian growers didn't know about, and they learnt about them by looking over the fence at them. So yeah, that's something that we'll be really interested to see evolve and unfold as the farm grows.
Oh, that's really exciting.
And we're also really wanting that farm to be a demonstration site and an education site, so that the public can come and learn about what's being grown there as well.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming in.
My pleasure. Thanks, Maddie.
For more videos, go to mildrewweekly.com.au.